Well, I think terrorism is being practiced on the residents of the city of Oakland, because many of the retired teachers, retired military people have informed me that they understand what's going on, and it's not anything that relates to humanitarian training whatsoever. This is a psychological, as we in the research community say, this is a psyops. They're preparing people for what is coming, not what is being presented today.
So you're saying they're preparing people to accept it with incrementalism?
That is correct. Like the old frog example. You know, you put the frog in the water and you just gradually continue to raise the heat on the water until the frog is cooked. And that's the way it works. The problem is that the local people in general, just will not take their heads out of the sand. And they don't realize that when the head's in the sand, the other part of the body is totally exposed to problems. And I don't care. If I'm just the only person screaming like the voice in the wilderness, if I'm only the Paul Revere of Oakland, I'm going to tell everyone I can, listen, we have a serious problem.
And it's called a police state.
It's called a police state.
After all the evidence you've seen in the last hour and a half, how could you deny what's going on? Well, if this hasn't convinced you, get ready. Local police in Alameda and Oakland working with the military, the U.S. military, the U.S. Marine Corps and Urban Warrior, as well as foreign troops, ladies and gentlemen. That's right, foreign troops right there on your screen. And having, speaking of screens, computers, satellites, tracking and watching. Meanwhile, the cameras are going up. It's time for us all to realize what's happening here. There you have it, tracking the population. My friends, this is totally unconstitutional, and looking at a historical reference, it is terrifying to see military working with police, then you add in foreign troops, paid actors saying, we're Americans, you can't do this to us. They're conditioning the police, the military, and the public. Think about it. It's clear the American people have been designated the enemy. I'm sorry, ladies and gentlemen, it's the federal government that is destroying the sovereignty of this nation, the United States of America. It is their problem. They're the crisis. They're the threat. They're the terrorist. And I'm sad to see our military and our police being merged, and to see them changing from peace officers and defenders of the country into thugs and bullies for the bureaucrats and their foreign banker globalist controllers.
Would be a microchip or a monitor that would be placed on each Marine that would monitor their vital signs. You work the same way as the person locator, if you want to call it that, where a doctor or a medic or a corpsman could monitor from a safe distance everybody's vital statistics, their blood pressure, their heart rate, their body temperature. Why is that important? The way it works now is when a squad goes on patrol, we'll have a medic with them.
They're expecting resistance, and what they get is CNN with cameras.
That woman lives there. Maybe her children are home asleep. But hey, they're going in there. I'm going to go in and rescue my kids, right? In the past, that might be interpreted as a hostile act. One of the technologies or work makes you nauseous. In the past, in a situation like that, she might have been shot. In the future, we want to give our Marines non-lethal options where they can say, no, she's not armed, maybe threatening, but I don't want to kill her, or I don't want to kill him or them. Use your sound wave rifle, I guess you could call it, and down they go.
You guys have heard of the sticky gun?
Yeah.
Sure you've seen that. Trying to come up with new stuff now for crowd control, etc. got a group of civilians that keep trying to break through a barrier. Instead of unloading with a saw into them, you just have a sticky gun. All of a sudden, boom, they can't move. All kinds of things the Marine Corps and the United States military is trying to do to minimize the amount of people that have to be killed.
Yeah, him in prison, huh?
Now you're going to see an execution.
So you can see, she went running in there saying, I live here.
Oh, but there's a prisoner. That's a hopeless mom.
Typical of what you see in an urban environment, people hanging out, doing nothing. And as we know, idle time is the devil's hands. Right? We've been saying people don't have jobs, they don't have a home to go to, or a home that they want to go to, so they just hang out all day long. You have a local religious leader over there and the nun. You have a church right here. You have some Marines conducting an interview over here, it looks like. Right now, everything's calm. Everybody seems to be content. But at any minute, this could erupt into a riot.
We were in Oak Knoll for 5 days in Oakland, California. But the footage you're seeing was amateur. You see, the media was taken on a staged tour. And you'll see some of our footage later. This is the guided tours for the public during the exercises. And when the Marines have a problem, or when the police have a problem dealing with the civilians, they call in the backup, and the battle begins. Oh, by the way, I hope you enjoyed seeing the foreign troops earlier, helping keep the Americans under control.
Due to the large number of people arriving, you will experience a short delay. Please remain calm and cooperate so that we can process you into the camp faster. Attention, attention, attention. Due to the large number of people arriving, you will experience a short delay. Please remain calm and cooperate so that we can process you into the camp faster. Please cooperate with all personnel.
Hey, don't run! Hey? Jelikus! Ja! Wat is dit? Ben ik hier te zien of niet? Hey, hou ook de dak in de gaten! Wat? Dak! Niet die op dak, niet die op dak! Nee, maakt niet uit! Ze moeten gewoon het dak in de gaten houden daar!
Wat jij?
Now watch how they treat this civilian. Boom! They kick him. Get out of there. He scurries past the foreign troops from the Royal Netherlands, and then they, in SWAT team style, stacked up, get ready to raid and kick in the doors. Besides, these people are lazy. They have to be dealt with. You heard the Marine Corps officer earlier, didn't you?
I need to see your commanding officer.
I'm very glad to see that the humanitarian assistance is going well. When the police can't handle it, they just call in the foreign troops. Everything's okay, working together, speaking English, speaking foreign languages, working with police, speaking English.
Hey, otherwise we're going to overwhelm them.
I think we're done.
attention, attention. American forces are here to help. Remain calm. We will not tolerate civil disobedience. Attention, attention, attention. American forces are here to help. Please, please remain calm. We will not tolerate civil disobedience.
Let's move right in the middle of the experiment. Need you to move.